Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean with Ray, day 45. First time in the history of Learning Korean with Ray. It is not 6 p.m. but 4 p.m. But I hope some of you are still watching. Let's see, yeah, there's already at least one person on the stream, so thanks for watching, whoever you are. And with that, we just go right into it. So we finished the vocabulary of lesson 5 yesterday on Memrise. And the next step will be learning the grammar of on howtostudykorean.com. But before we do that, we need to make sure that the vocabulary is really safe in our heads. So we do that on Memrise again. Some repeating. Hi, Shakito. Yes, die Stammzuschauer. Der Stammzuschauer. Yes. Okay, difficult words, let's do it. We have 5 difficult words. Museum. Okay, museum, I remember this now, is basically pronounced pang, not like this. Like this, pang, it's actually a pak, but it's pronounced pang because the next letter is an M. Pang mul. Yes. Pang mul guan. Guan. Pang mul. Mul. Guan. Go. Goa.
Pang mul guan.
Pangmulguan. Okay, breakfast, pretty easy. Morning meal. Morning is achim. Achim. And meal is shiksa.
Achim shiksa.
Achim shiksa. Achim shiksa. To make is mandelda. Man. Dil. Da.
만들다.
Also very easy. To be small, also very easy. 찾다. Not sure which one. I think this one. 찾다.
찾다.
And that's our difficult words. Not difficult at all. But we'll do a classic review. To expect it. So that's more difficult already. I want to say there's a gi in it. Gi seng? Is there a seng? No. Gi seng gida? Gi seng hara? To expect gi. Sengida? Is there a seng? I have to look at the options. No, there's no seng. Okay. Gide. Gide hada?
Gide hada.
Gide hada. Okay, okay. Today. Now, those are the new words that we have learned yesterday. Onim, 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 onim. Onil.
Onil.
Onil. The day after tomorrow. So tomorrow is something like 오대 치대 something like that with day, I think. And here we have the day after tomorrow. This is hard. Is it Bore? Bore? Bo? Bo? Bore? Chun. No, this was not in it. Da, I don't think so either. To. Cha. I don't know. It's orange, not red.
More.
I put the wrong E. It was actually correct.
More.
Oh, it was correct. Well, it was not correct, of course, but it was just the wrong E. I will count that as correct. Okay, Kung.
Kung.
Oh, the, all the days. Okay, I know Monday. I know Tuesday. I know Wednesday. I think I know Thursday. Like Bock, Bock, Bock. Bock, and then it was always Jo. Joil.
Mogyoil.
Nice. Got it. Okay, to study. Something like Boku, Bokuada, not sure. Oh, there's a Bu, Buhada, and then something else in front, I think. Tobu. Chom? No, Chom no. No, no, no. Hong, Hongbu no. Bubu no. Bom no. Kong.
Kongbuada.
Kongbuada. Kong. Ball. Kong. Kung. Kung. Kong, Kong. Wednesday is Su, Yoil. Su, Yo, Il.
Suyoil.
Suyoil. Sunday is Iryoil. Ir, Yo, Il. Ah.
일요일
일요일 Friday is 금요일 금
금요일
Tuesday is starts with an H huo huo Yoil? No, it was not Huo, it was Hoa. Hoa. Yeah.
화요일.
호아. 화요일. Okay, to joke. To joke is a hard one. Is it? What do we have here? Bonn. Ah, ja. Dungdamhada.
Dongdamhada.
Okay. Tomorrow? De Deal.
Neil.
Oh, that's already. I thought there was another syllable. Deal. Okay, nice. Yesterday. That was also something with. Il? No. Yesterday. I don't know. I have to look at the options. Okay, first one no. Second one no. This could be because I remember there was no consonant in one, I think. Obam? No. Oni. Oni no. Oje.
어제.
She gun. Shigan.
시간.
Day after tomorrow. 모레.
모레.
모레. Monday was a hard one. 우와. 우어. 우원. 우원. 요일. It's very close. Ah, wait, there was an R in the end, not an N. Ooh, war yoil.
월요일.
Nice. Okay, that's I can get that. Oh. Re, ore, doida, doi, ja, ore, doida, doi, da. Wrong E again.
오래되다,
Ore,
오래되다.
doida. Saturday was to. Toyoil.
토요일.
Okay, pretty decent, I would say. The ne the days were pretty nice. What did I do wrong? Not sure what I did. Ah, here. Day after tomorrow. More. Okay. Hi, Axel. Welcome to the stream. Why are you learning Korean? Well, I answer this question a lot, but quick summary. First, I just like to learn a language. I think it's a good thing to do. Like, needs discipline and so on. And it's just good feeling to know how to speak three languages. Second reason why I chose Korean specifically is because I always wanted to learn an Asian language, and I because I also like the Asian culture and so on, and I think Korean is the easiest of the Asian languages. And the third reason, and also one of the main reasons why I chose Korean specifically to learn a new language, is because my other hobby is the video game StarCraft. So I play a lot of StarCraft. I'm active in the StarCraft scene, and the StarCraft scene has a very big scene in Korea. There's a lot of content on the internet in Korean. There are a lot of people who are Korean, and just to be able to enjoy that hobby more, I want to learn Korean as well. Okay, so let's continue. I will go for a classic review and then difficult words. 50 words. Okay, there when it's farther away. That should be probably Chogi. Chogi.
Chogi.
Oh, you lived in Seoul for a year and a half. Your second question, will you go there? I have it not planned yet, but I have the goal to go to Korea once, at least. So it will happen at some point, but I don't have any specific journey planned yet. I can speak, read and write, but not very well. Okay, that's great. Did you learn it beforehand, or did you just learn it while you were there? Mostly while I was there. Okay. Yeah, nice. So if you say not very well, that depends on the person you ask. So this all is no problem for you, I guess. All these vocabulary here. Or conjugation for like past tense, present tense, future. Ah, okay. Yeah, so I'm doing a mix here. I'm learning vocabulary on this website called Memrise. I'm doing some grammar lessons on a website called howtostudykorean.com, which is this one. And yeah, there are many, many lessons here, up to 150. And I'm at lesson 5 right now. So this is the lesson I will do today. This is conjugation for like the different tenses, and before you do such a lesson you need to learn the vocabulary that is used in this lesson, and that's what I'm just doing here on Memrise right now. And then there I'm also using some YouTube videos to also from this website, from howtostudykorean.com, to practice my skills, practice what I've learned. So that's the rough structure of my stream here, of my project. Okay, to belong is Gilda.
Gilda.
To be happy. Oh, that's a little bit harder one. I want to say there's like hung in there, hung? Maybe hang? Hang. I have to look at the options. Can you construct sentences yet? Constructing sentences, yes, I can, but not with conjugation. So, for example, I know the different particles for your subject, object, particles for the place, like, yeah, some special things like many people or so. With Manta. Yeah, I can basically construct rough sentences with like order, subject, object, verb, or subject, adjective. And the difference is that the verbs are not conjugated yet. I'm always using the base form of the verbs. And I have not learned conjugation yet. So, yeah. If I want to say, I don't know, the teacher is, or yeah, I don't know, the teacher goes to school. Well, it's too difficult for me right now. I could do it, but it would take like 3 minutes or so. Actually, Son Seng Nim is teacher, Son Seng Nimin is the subject particle. Son Seng Nimin. Then we need school, Hakgyo with the place particle, which is E. So Son Seng Nimin, Hakgyo E. And then we need go, which is Kada. Son Seng Nimin, Hakgyo E, Kada. Like this. I'm not 100% sure, but it should be correct. But you can see that I'm using kada in the end, which is not the correct form of the verb. That's just the base form, the like unconjugated form. So that's what I will learn in the next lesson that I'm starting today and continuing tomorrow and the day after tomorrow and so on. But yeah, if you are interested in general, there is actually my YouTube channel. YouTube. Oh wow, wait 1 second. I have to switch my keyboard layout. Okay, YouTube. If you go to this YouTube channel, if you go to this YouTube channel, there's some StarCraft content, but there's also a playlist called Learning Korean with Ray. And if you go to this playlist, there are all my lessons. I'm doing 1 hour every single day. So this started like 45 days ago, and all the videos are uploaded here until yesterday. So this is from yesterday, and today is day 45. Yeah. So that's my progress. So I've been learning to construct sentences in the last like 3 days ago and like 5 days before that. So 8 to 3 days ago, around that. Okay, so let's continue. Happy is Gipada. Oh, there's no hang in it. But there's no gi in here. So maybe there are different, I don't know, gi? Ki? It's not here, so I always try to think about the word before I look at these options here. But then if I don't know it, I want to look at the options, and here I don't see a gi. Gipeda. Gipuda. It's not here, sadly. So I have to look at the options. I want to say this one was in it, to be honest. Okay. Ahengda no new Hengyuda no. Yeah, okay. I don't know. So I will just go to check.
행복하다.
행복하다. So I guess it's a different word. I guess there are multiple words for happy. But this one is what I've learned before. The Heng, yeah, the Heng. I knew the Heng, but I didn't know the rest. Heng Bokada. Heng, Heng Bok, Bok, Heng Bokada. Heng Bokada. Heng Bok. I need to use another mem here. Heng Bok. Yeah, I don't know. I will use this one.
행복하다.
Okay. Back to Korean. Heng. 복하다. Japan. Ilbun. Ilbon, Ilbon, Ilbon,
Ilbon.
To finish, ha, that was hard. Kanada or Canada? Canada. So Canada. So then it's Canada.
끝내다.
끝내다, 끝내다. Not Canada, but 끝내다. 끝내다. Okay, to eat, 먹다.
먹다.
Book is check.
Check.
Teacher, 선생님. 선. Sonsengnim.
Sonsengnim.
To understand, ihehada. Ihehada.
Ihehada.
To dance, chuchumada. Chu chum hada. Only da chum chuda. What? Is it not correct? Chu chum da chum chuda, maybe? Maybe other way around. Chum chuda. Okay. Room pang.
방.
Very 아주
아주
to speak 말하다 or 말하다
말하다
말하다 I formal 저
저
저 저 저 to walk. So to go is kada, and to walk was kinda similar. There was also like the ka, but there was something else, another consonant, like kat, katkada or so, kat, kat, 다. I'm not sure. Like this. Something else. 가게. 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 Only 가게. Kage was store. No, it's not Kage. Kage was store. Kage is store. So. Katkada. Okay, I have to look at the options. Oh, kot, not kat.
Kotta.
Ah, kotta. Kot, not kat. Got. Okay. To be good. Choda. Cho.
Jota.
Jota. Sopa. Man. So pa.
Sopa.
Father. Aboji.
Aboji.
Sada.
Sada.
Chang. Changmun.
Changmun.
Changmun. To be many. Manta.
Manta.
Ida.
Ida.
Television. Television. Probably wrong is. Ah, wait. Television. Ah, not television, television.
Television.
To practice. The verbs are the hardest ones for me for some reason. Yon supada? Something like that. Yon-sup-hada?
Yon-sup-hada.
Nice. Okay. Woman, yoja.
Yoja.
Yoja. Funny, interesting. Wow. That was one of with Ita in the end, so I know it was me, Ita, and there was something else in front. Che, I think Che.
Che-mi-ta.
Yeah, Che-mi-ta. To be new, Seropta, Seropta. Se. Orop da.
새롭다.
새롭다. 새롭다. 새롭다. 중국. 중국.
중국.
건말. 건물. 건말. 건말. Con, con, mal. Mul?
Con mul.
Okay, ist mul. Nun.
Nun.
Koyangi.
Koyangi.
Hengbokda. Hengbokada. Hengbokada.
Hengbokada.
John Huagi. Huagi. John. John. Huagi.
John Huagi.
Don Dengi. Don Dengo. No, no, no. Dang. Dang Dengo. Wait. Deng. Go. Dang Dengo. Don Dengo. Dating. God damn it. I have to look. Ah, it's oh.
Dengjango.
Dengjango. To go kada.
Kada.
Not an.
An.
Kot.
Kot.
Yol, yolda.
Yolda.
Pal.
Pal.
An.
An.
Yok.
Yok.
The airplane. Okay, so I know. Well, I think I know is hang in the middle. And then the other ones were not too big. So something like Bihengi or so. Bihengi. Bihengi?
Bihengi.
Oh, nice. Perfect. Bob Ross, 9/11. Hi. Not sure what you are referring to here. 9/11. I mean, yeah, airplanes are related to 9/11, but not sure what your statement is here. Uija. No, wait. Uija is correct. Uija.
Uija.
It's said airplane. I'm not sure, man. I don't understand. Kuda.
Kuda.
To be old. Nakta. but a weird one.
낙다.
To be expensive, 비싸다.
비싸다.
In front, 뒤. No, wait. In front. I know on top, I know below is meat. Ah, I know up.
Up.
Japji.
Japji.
Moon.
Moon.
Tone.
Dun.
Tarida.
Tarida.
Okay, pretty fine. We'll do difficult words and then I think we are ready for the grammar lesson. It's already 45 minutes later. Damn, time flies. Okay, to be happy. Hengbokda. Hengbokada. Heng. Bokada.
Hengbokada.
Mandilda.
Mandilda.
Bore. Bore. Bo.
Bore.
Bore. Breakfast. Achim Shiksa. Achim Shiksa.
Achim Shiksa.
Chakta.
Chakta.
Okay. That should be enough for the repeating. So now we will switch to howtostudykorean.com. There we are. Okay, so we learned the vocabulary. That is that. And now we go to the first chapter of this lesson, which is how to say I or me in Korean. Okay, first of all, I want to point out the difference between I and me in Korean. That's something I will never... That is something I never knew, realized until I started to learn Korean. You will find that learning a foreign language will vastly understand your increase your understanding of your mother language, mother tongue, and languages in general. In English, I and me have the same meaning, but they differ in their usage. When a speaker is the subject of a sentence, I is used. But when the speaker is the object, then me is used. I love you, you love me. In Korean, the same word is used, okay? There's no difference if subject or object. However, remember that there are different particles. Different particles will have to be attached to these words. Yeah, wow. You say they're the same word, but then you add a different suffix to it. So actually they're not really the same. together with the particle. Anyways, although the word... Oh, okay, well, if those are the normal subject-object particles, then of course it's true, then it's the same word. It does change based on the politeness of a sentence. Yes, we already know that one. Cho, cho, and na, na, na. Okay, that's the normal particles. Okay, then it's all fine. Chonin, chonin, nanin. Or, of course, this one that is very hard to pronounce. Rill. 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 Chorill. Chorill. I think most Koreans just say shorill. Chorill. I will actually check this.
Schorl. Schorl.
Okay. Oh, car can be attached to it. To indicate I is the subject of a sentence or clause, I already briefly distinguished between. Yeah, this was like the special particle for to have, I think. Takes years to fully grasp. Nice. More deeply in lesson 17 and 22. Okay. Ah, yeah, I know this one. I already learned about that. You basically change it. You change this. You basically fuse them together. The na plus the subject particle. Then it's ne. And jaw with subject particle with this one is J, and that's what they mostly use in the things I have seen so far. Oh wait, no, it's not changed. It's actually it's not fused. It's actually changed, and there's you still need the particle. Wait, then it was with the normal this one. If you have like nanin, you can just say ne. I'm pretty sure I've learned that before. But let's continue to read. They're all conjugated in informal style. In the next lesson, we'll learn more about formal and informal speech. Okay. But I'm pretty sure you use like this one and you don't need an additional particle for it. Like nanin is ne. I'm pretty sure. Let me check something. See? Ah, wait, that's with the possessive particle. Oof. Ah, yeah, here. Ah, that's the one I've learned. Okay, I mixed it up in my head. Okay, sorry. So, usually you say this one, which is na, and then the possessive particle to say my, but this is usually changed to ne. So, as you can see here, where is it? Where's the explanation that I just saw? Ah, okay. So now we is almost never used. You just use ne. So this is my, not me. Okay. So that's a bit weird. So you say neka, nega, nega. To say I as the subject, but you say ne without the ga if you want to say my. Okay, that's fine. If you say my, you will still have another noun afterwards that has the subject particle, so you just always have a subject particle. That's nice. Okay, in the lesson below, okay, we already did that. Okay, now we go to you, from I or me to you. You may have noticed that I haven't taught you one of those most common words in the English language. I know this sounds weird, but the word you is not said very often in Korean. Yeah, so I've learned, or we all together have learned in the first course of Memrise, the Korean One course, we have learned, for example, I love you, which is saranghaeyo, and sarang is love, and this heyo is just like this polite conjugation. You can also say saranghae, saranghae, and that's already I love you, and there's no you in it. As far as I know, there's just sarang and then some conjugation stuff, but it's not you. But let's see, that's only my like little knowledge that might be not perfectly correct all the time, as we just saw, but that's what I remember. So let's continue. Korean people get around saying the word you through a number of ways. Most of the time you use somebody's usual job position when referring to them or talking about them. Boss, principal, vice principal, Mr. Name, name something nim, customer guest. Okay, it's very common in Korean to refer to people that are close, that you're close with, as your own family member. For example, oppa, 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 oppa means older brother when you're a woman. But even if somebody is not your older brother, you can call him oppa if you're close to him. Hi. How was Korean study today? I came back for this. It was good. I repeated the vocabulary of lesson 5 that I learned yesterday. So now I have 100% of vocabulary of lesson 5 from howtostudykorean.com. And now I'm doing the actual lesson 5, which has the how to say I, me, or now how to say you in Korean. And then we go to conjugation of past, present, future. But I have to leave in 2 minutes, so I will just finish this chapter and then I will stop for today. And tomorrow it's about the conjugation. Somebody is not your older brother, you call him Opa. If you're close to him. Okay. Yeah, I've realized that already. You can call any woman or man that looks very old grandmother or grandfather. But other than that, you don't really call somebody part of your family unless you're close with that person. Okay. Okay, so very old people you can call like they're in your family, but only if you're very close to them. No, never mind. So if they are very old, you call them like this. And if they are not old, you only call them with family names when they are close to you, very close. Okay. You generally call any strange man or woman that you don't know. Ajosi. I thought that was also for older people, like old men not related to you. Men? Ajosi. And Ajumoni. Ajumoni, I think that was about older people, right? Not very old, but old. Yeah, but what is old? Is old like an absolute value, or is old in relation to you? So, for example, if I'm 50, let's say I'm 50, okay? And I'm speaking to someone who is... Or let's say I'm 40 and I'm speaking to someone who is 50. Is he old? Because he's older than me, or is he old because he's 50? Or what if I'm 10 and I'm talking to someone who is 20? 20 is not old, but for the person being 10 years old, that's older, of course. So is it in relation to the person who is saying it, or is it like an absolute thing? Like 50 is old, 70 is very old, 30 is not old. I can't tell you with confidence. Yeah, okay, it just comes from experience, I guess. Okay, I need to be quick now. I have to stop the stream any minute. In informal situations, you can use the word no, do. Can be attached to nor when you is the subject of a sentence, respectively. Subject or object? Yeah, okay, so normal object part and subject particles. If ka is added, then it changes to neka. Nega. Wait, we just had that as I, right? Jesus. Wait, am I reading this wrong? Nega. Ah, it's a different E. Shit. Okay. So I will never be able to learn the difference. Ah yeah, okay, it comes in next sentence. Maybe I should read one more sentence next time. You know, to the things, the pronunciation of nega from each other, which is secondly should be pronounced the same. Ah, okay, it should be pronounced the same, but to differentiate differentiate between them you use Niga. Niga. Okay. Niga. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say this word on Twitch. you can also use the word dung shin, which means you. You may use this word when talking to anybody, but Korean people hardly ever use it. Most people that say dang shin are foreigners and only do so because they're used to saying do you in a sentence. Okay, I have to really think about this to say the like position or family names and so on. Okay, so that will be funny in the practice videos for this lesson later on in like 2 days. But yeah, next time we'll go for the conjugation. Will probably be fun. So yeah, that's what we'll do today, tomorrow. And tomorrow will be at 6 p.m. as usual. Only today was a bit earlier. And yeah, that's it for now. So, thanks a lot for watching and bye bye, annyeong.